Hi, what do you think can be done to increase the power of the circuit? To get more power from the circuit, we need to use the Darlington configuration. But what is the meaning of Darlington? Pay attention to this circuit. This is the circuit of the car amplifier. This is an example. Darlington configuration is used in most circuits such as refrigerators, split coolers, washing machines, and so on. I am very interested in audio circuit. If you are also interested, write in the comments so that I can post many videos of audio circuits for you. There are two transistors here, one NPN and the other PNP. The part number are TIP35 and 36. These are power transistors, but in order to get good power, they should not be used normally. In this type of circuit, power transistors are always used along with two other transistors that are Darlington arrangement. I will explain in detail. Of course, a transistor like TIP122 use Darlington configuration alone. That is, there are two transistors inside this package. But in this circuit, these two are single and another transistor must be used. Let me give an example. Be patient and watch the video until the end so that we can conclude. This is an NPN transistor. If the voltage does not reach the base pin, the transistor is off, in the cutoff state. No current passes through the collector and emitter. If we give a voltage of about 0.7 volts to the base, the transistor will turn on. In fact, the potential difference between the emitter and the base must be more than 0.7 volts for this diode to conduct and the transistor to turn on. Of course, there are no diodes in the transistor, and this is just for understanding. But this amount is not enough for us, because we want to get a lot of power from this transistor. And this 0.7 volt only makes the transistor turn on. So, we have to increase the voltage on the base pin. That is, increase the potential difference between the base and the emitter. In this case, the base current increases, and a current passes through the collector and emitter, and it increases. But there is one important point. The voltage between the collector and the emitter is opposite to the current between the base and the collector. So, if the voltage increases, the current decreases. We know that the ratio of collector current to base current is called gain or HFE. The value of HFE is included in the data sheet of the part. Therefore, the gain is equal to the collector current to the base current. We want to get a lot of current from this transistor to supply the current required by the consumer. The consumer can be a motor or a lamp or anything. If we want to use an NPN transistor to start the circuit, often the voltage enters the collector and then reaches the consumer. But in PNP transistor, the voltage enters the emitter and not the collector. But why? First, I will draw a circuit. Collector, emitter, base. Often the consumer is connected to the collector. The voltage is here. The emitter is connected to 0 volts, which is the ground. The voltage enters the consumer and then reaches the collector. When the transistor turns on, this voltage reaches the emitter from the collector. The emitter was connected to 0 volts. So, the circuit is complete and the current flow in the circuit. But why is the consumer is NPN transistor not placed on the emitter? There are different ideas, but there is a simple reason. We know that for the NPN transistor to turn on, the potential difference between the base and the emitter must be greater than 0.7 volts to turn on the transistor. For example, there is 12 volts on the collector. This voltage reaches the collector from the consumer and reaches the emitter when the transistor turns on. We have a little voltage drop on the collector and emitter. So a lower value reaches the emitter, for example, 11 volts. Because the emitter is connected to 0 volt, it is enough for 0.7 volts to reach the base so that the potential difference between the base and the emitter becomes greater than 0.7 volts and the transistor turns on. Now, what happens if the consumer is connected to the emitter? For example, 12 volts enter the circuit. When the transistor is turned on, the voltage reaches from the collector to the emitter. We have a voltage drop on the collector and emitter. For example, 11 volts is placed on the emitter. To turn on this transistor, the potential difference between the base and the emitter must be above 0.7 volts. Here we have 11 volts on the emitter. So we need to apply 11.7 volts to the base to turn on this circuit. It is a bit difficult to prepare this voltage. For this reason, in NPN transistor, the consumer is placed on the collector, not the emitter. Now, let's go back to the main discussion or Darlington transistor. In order to turn on the power transistor, a suitable current must be supplied to the base. So, how should this flow be provided? For example, we want to use a microcontroller to control the transistor. This micro is not able to provide enough current to turn on the transistor. Therefore, it is better to use another transistor to turn on the power transistor, the Darlington configuration. Now, let's see how Darlington is configured. This is NPN transistor. We use another transistor to turn it on. The emitter is connected to the base. The collector are connected to each other. We use the same voltage and current. In this way, if we enter a small current into the base, the first transistor will turn on. Because the voltage and current are supplied from the main source, the current will go through the collector to the emitter and then the base of the power transistor. That is, with the input of a low current, we can provide the current necessary to turn on the power transistor. So, the power transistor is turned on with the help of the first transistor. And the micro can turn on the first transistor with a low current. What is important here is the flow rate. Here we have the flow coefficient increase. The flow coefficient of these two are multiplied together. I will give an example. We consider the HFE of the main transistor to be 100. We consider the HFE of the first transistor to be 10. The product of these two becomes 1000. So, the HFE of these two together is 1000. That's good, but there is still a problem. Because the two are connected, the base and emitter voltage must be higher. Consider this example. This is a datasheet of the TIP122 transistor, which is Darlington type. In Darlington package transistor, there are two resistors that are used to the turn off the transistor. When the base current of the first transistor is cut off, the power transistor is still on. So, R2 resistance is placed between the base and the emitter, which turn off the main transistor. The resistor R1 is also located between the base and the emitter, which turns off the first transistor. Now, pay attention to the amplifier driver circuit. Darlington configuration is present in this circuit. These are the two main power transistors that can be used of any type. One is NPN and the other is PNP. This is a class AB amplifier. Two more transistors are placed here. Pay attention to the configuration of these two transistors. They are both NPN. The emitter is connected to the base. The collectors are connected. The emitter of the transistor is the power as the output. So, with a small current that enters the base of the first transistor, the main power transistor turns on. They also realized that with the help of the Darlington transistor, we can receive a lot of current from the main power transistor. So the power will also increase. There is only one thing left. Because the voltage drop of the base and emitter is more than that of normal transistor, so this transistor heat up more when working and need a bigger cooling. Because two transistors are used, the response speed is also reduced. The HFE of a transistor can be seen in the datasheet. This is a datasheet of the TIP-122 transistor that I showed earlier. HFE of this transistor is 1000. HFE plays an important role in transistor operation. If the HFE decreases, the transistor will not work properly. I check an PNP transistor with the help of a multimeter. The multimeter is in diode mode. Base collector. Base emitter. By checking the multimeter, the transistor is shown correctly. Now, with the help of the T4 device, I want to check the HFE of this transistor. HFE shows the value of 2. The multimeter showed the transistor correctly. Well, with the reduction of HFE, this transistor cannot work properly in the circuit. So, when checking a transistor, be sure to check the HFE value. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe to my channel for the next videos. Thank you for watching the video.